Hi, my name is Priyanka Garg. I'm a PhD candidate working in Dr. Michael Sanguinetti's lab at the University of Utah, Salt Lake City. In this presentation, I will be narrating the video summary of our paper, Structural Basis of Ion Permeation Gating in Slow 2.1 Potassium Channels, published in the Journal of General Physiology in October 2013. In a typical voltage-gated potassium channel, the activation gate is formed by the crisscrossing of the intracellular ends of the four S6 segments, the so-called S6 bundle crossing. When the membrane is depolarized, the primary voltage sensors, that is the S4 segments, are outwardly displaced, and this movement causes the S6 segments to splay apart and open the bundle crossing gate. However, in cyclic nucleotide gated or CNG channels, the selectivity filter functions as the primary activation gate while the bundle crossing is always in an open conformation. When its intracellular ligand cyclic AMP binds to the C-terminal domain of the channel, the selectivity filter gate opens and the channel achieves a conducting state. In our paper, we explored the structural basis of the activation gate for SLO 2.1, a weakly voltage-dependent potassium channel that is activated by intracellular sodium and chloride. SLO 2.1 channels can also be activated by phenamates such as niflumic acid. We propose that unlike KV channels and similar to CNG and SLO 1 channels, the selectivity filter gates ion flux in SLO 2.1 in response to sodium binding while the bundle crossing is always in an open state. Verapamil and N-methyl verapamil, also known as D890, have proved useful compounds to probe the state dependence of the S6 bundle crossing in diverse channel types. We have used these drugs as structural probes to determine the state of bundle crossing gate in SLO 2.1 channels. SLO 2.1 channels expressed in Xenopus oocytes were activated by extracellular application of 6 millimolar niflumic acid or NFA. When current reached a steady state level in about 3 minutes, NFA was washed out to close the channels. 100 micromolar verapamil was then added to the perfusate while the channels were maintained in non-conducting state for 10 minutes by holding the membrane potential at minus 90 millivolts without pulsing. In the continued presence of verapamil, NFA was again added to the perfusate and pulsing to 0 millivolts was resumed. The peak current activated by the second application of NFA was reduced by more than 90% compared to the first application, indicating a state-independent block of SLO 2.1 by verapamil. The same experimental protocol was repeated in another oocyte using D890, a permanently charged membrane-impermeant analog of verapamil. Unlike verapamil, extracellular application of 100 micromolar D890 did not reduce iSLO 2.1 during the second application of NFA. This finding suggests that verapamil and D890 probably block SLO 2.1 channels from the cytoplasmic side of the membrane. The experiments with verapamil or D890 were repeated in several oocytes and the mean results are presented in panel C. To confirm the sidedness of block by these blockers, currents were recorded from inside-out macropatches in the absence and presence of intracellularly applied verapamil or D890. Both compounds caused nearly complete block of iSLO 2.1 in less than 1 minute. Together, these findings indicate that verapamil and D890 block SLO 2.1 channels from the cytoplasmic side as they do in all other investigated channels and in a state-independent manner, and the S6 segments do not form a physical barrier to drug entry into the central cavity. In 2011, Chen and Aldrich postulated that the S6 segments in SLO 1 channels undergo a dynamic rearrangement during channel opening or closing to couple intracellular calcium binding to the selectivity filter gate. We propose a similar mechanism for SLO 2.1 channels wherein sodium binding induces dynamic rearrangement of the S6 that is allosterically coupled to the selectivity filter gate. Alanine scanning mutagenesis of the S6 from threonine 252 to arginine 284 was performed to identify residues crucial for normal channel function. Almost all mutant channels were similar to wild type. However, when mutated to alanine, proline 271 and glutamate 275 exhibited complete loss of channel function. Since proline residues are known to cause local distortion of helical geometry, we propose that proline 271 may cause splaying of the S6 segments away from the axis of the central pore by introducing a kink. As shown in panel B, mutation of E275 to hydrophobic or polar residues caused complete loss of function, while mutation to highly polar or basic residues retained channel function. These results suggest that together with proline 271, glutamate 275 residues maintain the inner pore in an open configuration by preventing the formation of a tight S6 bundle crossing. If the selectivity filter functions as the activation gate in SLO 2.1, then sodium binding to the C-terminal domain of the channel must be allosterically coupled to the distant selectivity filter gate. Scanning mutagenesis of the pore helix identified F240 as a critical residue in channel activation. Mutation of this residue to cysteine induces constitutive channel activity, and unlike wild-type channels, this mutant is not further activated by NFA or elevation of intracellular sodium. In this homology model of SLO 2.1, F240 is located at the base of the pore helix and interacts with three residues in the S6 segment and L209 in the S5 segment. Mutation of L209 in S5 and F258, M262, and A266 in S6 segment to polar residues increase the constitutive channel activity in the absence of NFA and also increase the sensitivity to this activator. These findings suggest that hydrophobic interactions depicted here stabilize the closed state of the channel and that disruption of these residue interactions underlie channel opening. In conclusion, we use two experimental approaches to show that the main features of SLO 2.1 channel gating resemble that previously described for CNG and SLO 1 channels. First, we demonstrated that inhibition of SLO 2.1 by verapamil and its quaternary derivative D890 is not open state dependent, implying that the S6 bundle crossing does not restrict drug access to the central pore. Second, scanning mutagenesis of the S6 segment and directed mutagenesis of the S5 segment and pore helix identified several residues critical for normal channel gating. Together, our findings indicate that the selectivity filter, not the S6 bundle crossing, serves as the primary activation gate that controls ion permeation in SLO 2.1 channels.